Namaste, Aries, my favorite hard-ass motherfuckers. How are we? Friday. So, I've pulled three cards from the Oracle of Angels. So we're getting three messages straight up. I'm gonna do like a past, present, future sort of reading. We have I am beautiful. It's a 37, so that's a 10, one. And then liberation, which is 34. Liberation, that's like some sort of awakening, ascending. And then we have the eternal light of love. This feels like you are realizing your worth. You're realizing your worth, Aries. You're owning it. And you're becoming the boss. Like, look at the girl in the first one. She's like looking at that yellow bright light. You know, it looks like it could be that. And then you get closer and you've got looks like Michael with the sword. This to me feels like releasing someone, knowing your worth, and like being absolutely comfortable within yourself. You could be dealing with a Cancer or a Capricorn. Don't know why that come out, but I'm gonna pull three. The Emperor, the Fool, liberation, yes. And death, the eternal light of love. You could be dealing with a Scorpio. The Emperor. Authority. Aries. Well, that's you. That's you. I am beautiful. Aries. The Emperor. Well, I didn't even realize that was your card that came out. I am beautiful. You're realizing your beauty. Hey, look how. She even looks like she's parading, little dress on and shit. I feel like I'm connecting with a feminine. Could be dealing with Scorpio, definitely Scorpio, Cancer, Capricorn. Might be seeing a lot of butterflies. You have a lot of light, but a lot of beautiful light, Aries. I feel like you're someone not to fuck with, but you are so very, like, very nurturing at the same time. You have this very loving feeling about you. Liberation and the Fool. That's. Look at the crocodile. Maybe you're realizing someone was being a crocodile. But you're trusting. You're trusting. You're walking away from it, and there's a rebirth from within. There's a rebirth from within. Or you could be connecting with a Scorpio. If you're connecting with a Scorpio, Aries, get ready for fire. A very passionate connection. Very passionate connection. And you both know it. You both know it. All right, what is that energy connecting these guys? Energy for Aries. Caring connections, yeah, there you go. Number five, resonate. When that was the Emperor, the Empress. Four. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah. Caring connections. Could be connecting with someone that's in a loving connection. And there's, you guys are leveling up together. Congratulations, Aries, if you're in a divine connection and it's working, you're learning from each other. Touche. I forgot. Please like, share. Share to any Aries that you know that might benefit from hearing this. And subscribe if you haven't. Thank you for everyone that has. Like, subs are just fucking climbing. It's crazy. All right. The Fool, Liberation, The Thinking Man, 46, 10. Yeah, zero. So the Fool is the Thinking Man. Look at that. You're moving forward, but you're being very strategic about it. You're being very strategic about how you're approaching this connection. Because you care about them. You really do, Aries. And I feel like they really, really care about you too. They know that this connection is something very deep and spiritual. Yeah, look at that. Community. Death. Celebration after transformation. Aries. That's boss. Look at that. Be connecting with an Aries, masculine or feminine. If it's a feminine, like, you're very, very, very attractive, like fiery attractive, to the point where even girls look twice at you. I notice you get a lot of attention from females as well as males. Could be eating a lot of fruit. If you're not, you should be. Community. Caring connections, thinking man, community. I feel like you could be giving back to the community as well. Even donating like stuff to, like, you know, the Salvos and Lifeline and stuff like that. Go down and donate your time, or, you know, just something so simple. That's giving back to the community, you know. And it helps. If you don't have much to do, but I feel like you do, Aries, I feel like you're pretty busy, then, you know, help someone and then you'll figure out what you need to do next. All right, this is the Crystal Tarot. Everyone's well. How's your week been? Nice and peaceful, no stress, hopefully. Not working too hard. All right. Let's get some cards to connect all these. Eh? What does Aries need to see for that high score? What does Aries need to see for the high score? Judgment. That's a cool card. I look back with compassion for myself. Yes. The Emperor. Look, it even looks like he's holding something as well. He is. He's holding like a horn. I am beautiful. I look back at myself with compassion. you're moving forward. I feel like there's been like some massive healing that's happened for you guys, Aries. And I feel like it could help with your relationships, which is good, you know, because hurt people hurt people. And if we can stop that cycle, well, why wouldn't we? You know what I mean? Judgment. Yeah. Now, if you want to be with this person, you got to make a judgment call. You know, sitting on the fence and not doing nothing is still making a choice. You can't sit on the fence forever, because then eventually the universe will just push you over. Knight of Pentacles, the thinking man. Interesting. Look at this. Look at this. The Fool, the thinking man. I deserve financial security. Journeys. You're on. What people don't realize is when we start doing some like deep internal healing, that actually opens up like pathways through for us. You know, when we we're doing that work on the inside and we're releasing all that shit that, you know, that triggers us and makes us lash out at other people when they're doing nothing wrong. That's amazing. I look back with compassion for myself. 10 could be a significant number. 7, 7, 7, 1, 1. Yeah, 777, I'm seeing 777. I deserve financial security. Yes, you do. And I feel like you're walking towards it. Aries. And I feel like this love for yourself, this newfound liberation of love for yourself is gonna like spark something within you, Aries. Yeah, look, it's literally gonna spark something within you guys, and you're gonna take off. Like, seriously, it's the time of millionaires, billionaires, and people watching people become millionaires and billionaires. There's only gonna be three types of people. Let's see if we can't even out this fucking playing field for everyone. One more card, please. Yeah, look at that. Ace of Cups. I welcome new love and trust what it brings. Wow, what did I just say? I welcome new love and I trust what it brings. Ace of Cups. Aquamarine. Death, Scorpio, change, transformation, new beginnings. Wow. Yep. Ace of Cups. I welcome new love and trust what it brings. I feel like you're gonna have options. If you're single, you're gonna have like lots of options coming up, and it's only because that fire inside of you, you're lighting that love for yourself up inside, and people seriously, people get drawn to that shit, trust me. Don't go loving yourself too much, otherwise you'll attract too much attention. One more for message, please. Yeah. Four of Cups. I listen to my heart and follow my knowing. Exactly right. Exactly right. Guys, that was an amazing reading. If you're in a connection, it's leveling up. Users are ascending together. You're bossing up. You got a boss and a boss set, which is like what everyone wants, right? Trust in it. Be gentle with the connection. And just remember, hurt people, and we can stop that karmic cycle. We can stop that karmic cycle. But it starts with us, like Michael Jackson said, man in the mirror. You know, it's gonna start with the person you're looking at in the mirror first. Anyway, Aries, that's a fucking amazing reading. Keep leveling up, guys. Everyone's charging. It's sick, you know, like it's just gonna be a world full of fucking tarot readers and life coaches soon, you know, just helping everyone ascend. Seriously, it's fucking dope. I can see the good unraveling, and I'm happy. I'm so happy. Aries, I fucking love you guys. I love the energy you guys carry with you. I love how arrogant you can be without even trying. And it's just that confidence in themselves. Like, you know, there's a fine line. I know a lot of cocky Aries, but I know a lot of confident Aries too that are humble as fuck, you know? Anyway, I love you guys so much. Please like, share, subscribe. If you're still watching, kudos. You guys are the reason why I'm getting airtime. Hope the message helps. If you think it could help someone, please share it with them. Get them to come and sub. I'm gonna start doing personal readings soon. So I'm gonna get the website working on it. Everything's all in play. So won't be long and I'll be able to do private readings. And I'm gonna have a bit of a selection too. You know, not just gonna be love or work. We're gonna look at chakras and family karma and stuff like that. The little bits and pieces and get like real nitty gritty readings so we can pinpoint, you know, what's going on. So we can remove these blockages so we can all be fucking abundant. Love you guys. Have a safe weekend. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.